In the first centuries when Greek culture emerged, the decoration of pottery was dominated by geometric patterns and a lot of circular and wavy patterns too. There were a few figurative elements, probably inspired by Crete, where the Minoan civilization was flourishing at the time, but not that many. The practice to depict characters and scenes on pottery really took off and dominated from the 7th to the 3rd centuries BC. And production of vases was dominated at the time by Athens. You know that ancient Greece was not a single state, at least not until it was unified later by Alexander the Great. It was a cultural area with a collection of small states, and the city-state of Athens was one of the most important. Athens invented the so-called red figure technique, that is to say, a black background with characters painted in shades of yellow to red. Before, characters were typically painted in black on a red background. And in production centers, vases and other vessels became a support of choice for artistic expression, in a sense similar to painting on a canvas in modern painting. And the Greeks also developed a white ground technique later, by the end of the 6th century BC. Black figures and red figures were obtained through the application and firing of thin layers of slips. Slips are mixtures of minerals diluted in water. These colors were not painted on vases after firing. They were part of the vase itself. The white ground technique was based on paint itself applied on white clay, and it was a valuable innovation because it allowed for more colors on vases. It is this mix of technical innovation and artistic value that made the Greeks dominate this trade in the Mediterranean. Their clients also knew pottery, of course, and produced their own vessels, but they just couldn't do what the Greeks were able to do in terms of technical achievement and style. And production in Athens or other cities was a true industry, perhaps the first example of an industry for consumer goods, because the production of other goods like textile or furniture was much more decentralized, whereas pottery was mass-produced to meet strong demand for elaborate luxury goods or for transport of food and beverages all around the Mediterranean Sea.